Thanks, Stefanie, for joining me today. Let's have a conversation about hybrid cloud, something a lot of folks are talking about, but I'm interested in hearing kind of your point of view. So let me first ask you about Red Hat's position, marketing, go-to-market strategy as a cloud company, because you're not a cloud provider, but what is your role in helping customers realize their vision for hybrid cloud?
Yeah, I think it's an interesting point. If you go back in the industry 5 years ago, right, cloud was probably one of the most overused and most least defined terms that in the marketplace. Now, I think as we look at what cloud means to customers, it's really about having a choice in where and how they deploy their workloads. And it could be a private cloud on your premises. It could be a managed cloud. It could be a public cloud provider. It could be multiple public cloud providers. And so when we talk about cloud from a Red Hat perspective, it's about making sure that all of those options, even including, you know, kind of new ways clouds are being used, whether it be as a service or a software as a service or a platform as a service. Our view is, how do we bridge and link all of those possible definitions of what cloud has become and provide accessibility to it? And so our focus is not so much of being a single destination point of what cloud can mean to someone, but how do we provide accessibility to all the things that cloud could mean to someone?
One of the things I've seen you guys say is cloud is not an end state. One of the things, when I talk to clients, a lot of them are still, their vision of journey to cloud is, I got to get to AWS, or I got to get to Azure, or I got to get to Google. And so it's this lift and shift or shift and lift. That's where we're going. That's the end state, right? But you guys have a different point of view there, right?
Yeah, exactly. And I think in the, you know, in the market, that view is maturing as well. I think as more of these capabilities of cloud become available, because technology is rising, right? And we have various aspects to, you know, machine learning as a service, or Kafka as a service, or, you know, just infrastructure as a service. As all of those things continue to evolve, I think folks' view of their changing needs is more becoming a focus on, how do I prepare myself to use that change and to be able to get innovation from that change, rather than saying, I know how the world is going to look in 1 year, in 2 years, in 3 years, and therefore I am starting here and I am going to end there. I think what is starting to become clear is, with all the innovation happening from so many different vendors, and, you know, this is where open source plays a key role, because open source provides kind of an ability to build upon and interact and have interoperability. Building upon that, now it's about all of these capabilities being able to link and augment one another. And so our view about having it be a capability and not a destination is really about providing a few strategic decisions that prepare you to leverage the innovation and the change that's yet to come. That we may not even know what's going to come yet, but we know there's going to be new innovation, and we know it's going to be built on Linux just because of how the public clouds have evolved. So that's what we mean. And I think it's less clear, even within the customers I talk to, that this is the final destination I want to be at. I think what it is today I have a workload that runs best here, and I'm going to test that out. I'm going to drive it there. And then perhaps as I add in new capabilities or new vendors come about, I may want to move that workload elsewhere. So how do I prepare myself for that flexibility, rather than, you know, it's a clear go from point A to point B?
I'd like to go back a minute, because you mentioned a while back when we were talking some strategic decisions, both ones that you, Red Hat, has made, and one that customers or clients are facing. So I'd like to explore that a little bit and talk about what you mean.
Yeah, so we really believe that if you look at where the innovation is happening today, there are two key things that keep showing up. One is open source. Open source has changed the way development is being done. It is moving innovation at a much faster rate. And because of all the standards and the interoperability that is inherent into open source, that allows flexibility. So moving to an open source strategy, we're seeing more and more customers recognize that that is a foundational choice that is going to allow them to use what's available today and bridge to what's going to be built tomorrow. Core and critical to that certainly is Linux. And Linux has become the equalizing playing field that is foundational to many of the innovations we see today.
Obviously, containerization of applications, building applications around microservices, creating that portable set of code, as long as it's built on Linux, that can move to different environments is key. Where those environments move requires some evolution in edge computing, right? Like, how can I deploy this container out to a smaller server or even a device that's capable of hosting a Docker container and being deployed and managed by Kubernetes? I see a lot of that, things like some of the stuff that you guys briefed me on. There's another open source Kube Edge that's applying Kubernetes to Edge in the telco space. It's really interesting. But the thing that kind of glues that all together is all the advancements we're watching in the networking space, like virtual networking infrastructure, software-defined WANs, low-power WANs, and the translation between low-power and Wi-Fi and TCP/IP. All that advancement in the networking space is what's going to enable, I think, the edge to become the new target architecture of hybrid clouds, right? It's not going to be data center or public cloud. It's going to be data center, public cloud, and a variety of edge environments that are very heterogeneous and hard to manage in the traditional way.
Yeah, I agree. And so as you start to look at what the future of hybrid cloud becomes, right, mm-hmm. it becomes a real equal opportunity access. So how do I prepare myself to have equal access to what I currently have in the four walls of my data center, mm-hmm. how I leverage public clouds and major public cloud providers, how I prepare myself to leverage edge and pull all of that together. And, you know, when we look at how someone would build that up, it's really about creating a foundation built upon Linux. Clearly that's where we focus our RHEL mm-hmm. product, bringing in the capabilities of flexibility around mm-hmm. things like application movement and cloud native and microservices, as you talked about with Kubernetes and our focus with OpenShift. And then how do you manage it all? You made a good point about management. I mean, with this kind of a complex environment, management and automation become really, really key to the decisions that you make. And this is really how we at Red Hat have built up our entire portfolio. It's about how do you create a solid platform that has an ecosystem right. that is sustainable and relevant, and how do you then bring in the additional capabilities that are needed with management and automation in particular, but really right now in today's world, that's just key to scale.
Thank you for the time. This is a fascinating conversation, and look forward to see what you guys do next.
Yeah, great. Thanks. Nice to talk with you, Brian. I look forward to doing it again and to see where all of this goes.